Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
My name is Khari Lee. I'm a decoy and a dog trainer. We got Oskar out here. He's a Zeven's son, and some of you might have seen him on previous shows. And he's 2.5 years old now. He was bred to be a service dog, but he's really a protection dog / service dog. As a protection dog, I would grade him at a B+. Because he's only 2.5 years old, we're asking a teenager to do a man's job, but he's doing that job pretty well. He literally was bred to be a service dog, meaning in the sense of he was bred to be kind of, you know, low top, low demeanor, you know, good to go around, social, not at all any type of like, you know, aggression, anything in a sense, but you want a dog whose energy and demeanor can be controlled. And by that, a service dog, you want to know that the dog is very stable. And stability comes from a calm demeanor. You know, that's what most service dogs are, very calm, because you need a very calm and stable dog to be a service dog. Zeven is the same. So Oskar was bred to be the same.
Zeven, you're silly.
Like a person that was protecting you. You want the same thing in a dog. Very stable, very calm, very confident in itself, but very, very stable. That has to be the most important thing with a dog, a PTSD or a protection dog. The difference between a service dog and a protection dog is energy and drive. That's the most two attributes that you would want. The difference in a service dog, you don't want that much energy and you don't really need that much drive. But in a protection dog, you need drive and you need energy, definitely. The service dog is much more passive, much more in the sense of just letting a person be calm, giving a person a peace of mind that they can have, you know, they can have to go out, they can do things that they weren't able to do before, or they might not be able to do physically because of their, whatever they're, you know, diagnosed with. By breeding a service dog in Oskar, you put a lot of the qualities you want in a protection dog as far as stability, as far as attentiveness. With the training and my background as being a decoy, we tapped into his genetics and we woke up the protection side of him. With his energy, it was low in the first and the demeanor was a little different, but we tapped into that and he got drive now. He truly is a protection dog / service dog. To tap into his protection side of his genetics, I had to tap into his prey drive and his play drive. By doing that, you're able to bring out the qualities that you're probably gonna see on the documentary. He's very, 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 very agile. He loves to work, and he understands why he's doing the work. And that's what you need to have a true protection dog. I didn't work on defense. I worked on a lot of prey and play, because the dog needs to understand that everything is fun. As a decoy and a trainer, I work with a lot of different breeds as far as protection. Malinois, Dutch Shepherds, German Shepherds, Czech Shepherds, Rottweilers, Dobermans. I work with a lot of different breeds. But as far as Oskar and the Rottweiler, there's no more power than that. They are the most powerful protection dogs in the business. With the techniques I've taught him, he just understands. His intelligence allows him to understand what the physical body is capable of doing. By understanding what the body's physical capability is doing, Oskar, he shows you what your body is not capable of doing. That's the difference between him, but that comes from intelligence. As far as protection work and sports work, the most elite breeds are usually the Malinois, the German Shepherd, and the Dutch Shepherd. In comparison to those three breeds I just spoke about, Oskar is right next to him. But literally because of his intelligence first, not his physical or his agility, it's his intelligence. Since we started training with him at 4 months, Oskar has shown me an intelligence that I've never seen in a Rottweiler. In my honest opinion, I've never seen it. His ability to understand why and what I'm teaching him is uncomparable. With a Rottweiler like Oskar, now I have 105-pound, intelligent, athletic, and willing to do everything I've taught him to do. The same thing a Malinois would do, same thing a Dutch Shepherd would do, same thing a German Shepherd would do, but it's a Rottweiler. As far as the power aspect, he got overdrive where the other dogs don't. He's a true man stopper. When I say man stopper, I don't care what man, how big, where you coming from, how you gonna get there, he gonna stop you. He understands the human anatomy like I've never trained any other Rottweiler. He understands how to break a man down. Literally, Oskar is a beast. When I'm working with Oskar, he hits me in ways that I've never been hit before. He hits me in ways that I've never thought I could be hit before, but it all comes from his intelligence, from me teaching him how to use the sleeve, use the suit, understand things like even just being 2.5 years old, he's far surpassed a lot of the things that I've taught other Rottweilers at that age. Oskar versus a German Shepherd. You get a lot of the same attributes, but there's definitely tremendous more power in a Rottweiler. At the pace he's going, we'll be right there with them soon. The ability he has, the intelligence, the courage, the willingness he has, is gonna have him right where I think he should be. Oskar's courage is exceptional because of the training I put in. He understands things. When a dog understands why they're learning them, when they're learning them, it really helps their courage. Oskar's courage is superior to a lot of the dogs I've trained, and I mean all breeds across the board. Oskar versus a Malinois, intelligence, damn near equal. Physicality surpasses. Power surpasses. Agility almost as equal. You can find a lot of attributes in a Malinois that you can find in some Rottweilers, like Oskar. He's not like any other Rottweiler I've ever worked. His intelligence, as far as what we worked on and how we worked on it, how clear he understands what I'm teaching it and why I'm teaching it to him, that makes his intelligence just as tight as any Malinois. Oskar is everything a Malinois is. That's why I think we're talking about him today. His in-tuneness with his help, his handler and his owner, is I've never seen it before. As far as the qualities and the understanding the intricacies of their lifestyle and how they're living it, he has all the intelligence and the qualities that a Malinois has. When you see a Malinois, you understand the dog can do a lot of different things as far as scent detection, as far as their speed and their movement. But when a Rottweiler does it, it's all done with power. And that's the difference to me with the Rottweiler and the Malinois. We got 2 years to go. We got 3 years to go. He's going to be a good dog versus a Malinois if we put the work in. Oskar versus a Dutch Shepherd. Ooh. The power is almost the same, but it's just a little more power for the Rottweiler because the mass and the speed is not the same as the Dutch Shepherd, but as far as the power and the courage, oh, it's equal. It's almost equal. As far as the future, I'm really excited for Oskar because he's only 2.5. Being 2.5, the future is bright for us. I know by the time he's 5 years old, he's going to be exactly where I want him to be. We got a pace right now to teach him everything I want him to learn. And as he grows and matures, he's gonna be way bigger and better than I ever thought he would be.